On the job this morning, we are getting social with our business networking. A new survey from the staffing firm Office Team is shedding light on professional networking, the most popular ways to grow your contact base, but also the most frequently made mistakes. Bob Nealon is with Office Team in Providence and joins us this morning with more. Good morning, Bob.
Hey, good morning. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. Always good to see you. Networking is so important in business. We all know this, whether you're looking for a new job or you're looking to shift careers. You have to network. And there were some results of a new survey that indicated that social networking and business networking may be changing. What were the results of that survey?
Yeah, so we tried to find what people thought was the most efficient way to network, and about 47% of the responses that thought online media was the best way, most effective way to network, which has kind of changed gears over time. It really kind of, the old traditional way of meetings and in-person professional networks is starting to take a backseat to the online presence.
Well, people then may think that, okay, I only need to network, you know, socially online. But I would think that that in-person networking is still very important, because really you can't replicate that sort of one-on-one contact, can you?
No, I mean, the online part is allowing you to spread yourself more thin, get in touch with more contacts, kind of potentially, you know, find more avenues.
Right.
But I think the in-person thing, people are missing the boat if they're not continuing to do that pretty aggressively. You need to really establish a connection with somebody. If you build some rapport, they're more apt to help you and try to be more, you know, beneficial to the relationship as opposed to just a really quick conversation online. So the in-person thing's still very important.
Yeah, sure. And as it says here, the statistics indicate, you know, 42% of people said, you know, not asking others for help is the number one mistake. Why would people be hesitant not to reach out? Is it just that they think they can do it all on their own? We don't want to ask, you know, for directions, especially men when we're driving.
Sure.
Stuff like that.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't people want to reach out?
Well, I think there's a little bit. There's a little bit of self of pride. You want to do it on your own and certainly be able to find your own opportunity. I also think people get the impression they may be putting somebody out. If you don't know the person that deeply, or you've only been exposed to them a couple times, a couple conversations, you don't know maybe how much is too much to ask them for. But the reality is they really enjoy the initiative. They like you talking and being aggressive and showing the interest, and they tend to buy into that more as opposed to someone who's a little bit more dormant with their process. So.
Sure, and this is a tough one too. You know, you want to maintain the relationships that you have, and I would think some people would have difficulty with that. And also, you don't want to become a burden to anybody. You want to stay in touch, you want to maintain, but you also don't want to be inundating them too much. How do you walk that fine line?
Well, I think that's how you also bring in the social media side of it, the online presence. You can obviously, you want to make sure you continually follow up. A lot of people make the mistake of only networking when they need a new opportunity. They don't continue while they're situated. I think that shows that you're just in it for kind of what you're in for yourself.
Yes.
You know, posting articles or relevant things about your industry or how you can help other people shows a nice presence while you're not really active in your search, and that's a way to kind of keep in touch with people without having to dial everybody individually or things like that. So you can use the balance there with the online media to help with that as well.
Sure, and you just hear over and over again that you need to maintain and stay in touch with people, but I know when I was looking for work, I just felt I don't want to be inundating them constantly, so it is tough for people.
Yeah, and I think there's a balance. You just got to take the cues from the individuals you're working with. Some people really enjoy the go-getter that's on top of you and really kind of try to follow up with you consistently. Some people want less follow-up because it takes a lot of time. So I think you need to read the cues. You need to follow up with individuals immediately, ask them what's best to follow up, and then you can kind of develop your process as you go, and each individual might be a little bit different.
Well, these are great tips, and hopefully they can help people get back to work, or they can help get them to the next opportunity, because that's really what it's all about, isn't it, Bob?
Absolutely. Networking is extremely key, so hopefully it helps.
All right, Bob, thank you so much.
No problem.
Love
Thanks
that
for
tie,
me.
Buddy.
I appreciate
Very
it.
Nice, my
all
friend.
Right.
Bob Nealon, everyone. And if you want even more information from Office Team Networking on all the great networking opportunities out there and tips and so on and so forth, just head to our website. It's the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com.